up guys, welcome to VickGeek channel. Welcome back to another video. Now as you guys know, I make a lot of mobile photography tips and tricks related videos. You guys seem to watch my videos, like my videos, but then you forget to subscribe. So don't forget to subscribe if you are new to my channel and watching this video. So in this video, I'm going to talk about the Samsung Galaxy S7's triple camera setup, and I will be sharing some of the tips and tricks that I encountered while actually playing with this camera settings, or rather camera of this mobile phone. Now, of course, this won't be a full detailed camera settings of the Samsung Galaxy S7. I'll be making separate video about that. So pretty much any camera settings that's available on the Samsung Galaxy S7 and how you should actually better utilize it, that will be in another video. In this video, just tips and tricks about the Samsung Galaxy S7's camera. Now, as you guys know, there are three cameras over here. One is the 24 megapixel at f1.7. And another one is the 8 megapixel camera at f2.4 aperture. Now this ultra wide camera at 8 megapixel is very, very wide, and it has fixed focus. So you make sure you keep that in mind. There is no autofocus or focus control over the ultra wide camera. Of course, you don't need any focus while capturing such a wide shots. First tip that I would like to share you is make sure there is no person on either side of the camera while you are capturing. Say that I'm framing it this way, and make sure that on either end of the camera's perspective, make sure there is no person standing over there. Otherwise, the person's image will be very much distorted because it is an ultrawide camera. So the person's image will obviously be very, very weirdly distorted. So you should keep that in mind. Make sure if you are having any persons, if you want to capture any buildings or cityscape, and if you want some persons to be standing over there, make sure that the person is standing in the middle of the frame, not on corners of the frame. So that thing you should keep in mind while you capture ultra-wide shots. So alright, so moving on, the second tip I would like to share is inside the camera settings. So let's take a look at it. So guys, as you can see, there is some building over here. Now ultrawide shots is really helpful while capturing scenes like this. So make sure you use the ultrawide angle whenever you are into these kind of situations or scenes. So now as you can see, this is the Samsung Galaxy S7's default camera user interface. As you are seeing, there are actually two icons over here, one with only two trees and another with three trees. So three trees in the sense this should be an ultrawide angle camera. So if you just tap on that, as you can see how much wide it gets. So make sure you are not holding the camera with your fingers, otherwise your finger might just interrupt the camera's lens. Because it is ultra wide, make sure you are holding the camera in this way. This is the professional way how you hold your mobile phone camera, not like this, not like this, not like this, or don't even think of holding it like this or other weird angle. So make sure you're holding the mobile phone's camera like this very steadily. I have also made some tips and tricks video about how you should actually compose the image, or rather hold the camera steadily without any shakes. So make sure you watch that video. So guys, as you can see, this is the ultra wide angle. Now like I said, for the shots like this, for the places like this, always use the ultra wide angle. And if I capture, see how much information I get in just one image. This is really awesome. Now, as you can see, there are actually trees over here. There is this little pond, artificial pond, and also covering the green grass. Now just imagine if there is any person standing over here, so it will be covered as well very nicely. Now you might say, what if I capture with the normal angle? Now as you can see, the trees are actually missing, and again I need to recompose the image in order to get the way I want the image. So as you can see, I have to recompose the image and then capture the image, but still I miss so many frames inside one picture. So I would suggest for cityscapes, for buildingscapes, or even for landscapes, always use the ultra wide angle camera. That way it will help you get some really, really nice shots without missing any much in the frame. So guys, another angle just I wanted to share you how you can actually utilize the ultra wide angle. So if you are not satisfied with that kind of image I showed you earlier, now you will see the utilization of this ultra wide angle. Now this is the normal angle, as you can see, double trees over here. This is just the normal camera, 24 megapixel at f1.7. Now if I am trying to capture, actually there is so much missing in the frame. Although I am really close to the building here, as you can see, the building is right behind this camera, but still it's covering at around 26 millimeters. Now, but still you will see that there is so much thing that is missing inside this field of view. So what I can do is switch to the ultrawide angle. Boom, there you go. Pretty much every frame that I want inside one image is right over here with this ultrawide angle. Now if I just take a picture, as you will see how awesome the images come, and pretty much everything is covered in just one image. This is the kind of thing that you want to utilize while you use the ultrawide angle. So I hope this tip will help you. Hit that like button if you enjoyed this tip. Alright, moving on to another tips that I would like to share you about this Samsung Galaxy S7 camera. So the next tip I'm going to share you about the auto scene optimizer. Now as you can see, in situations or rather subjects like these flowers, what you can do is bring the camera's user interface. Now use this scene optimizer, not auto mode. So do not use auto mode to capture flowers or other things, close up subjects. Use the scene optimizer so that it gives you nice color rendition for any image. As you can see, it quickly identified the flower, as you can see with the symbol over here. Now if I just use the tap to focus, always do not forget to use the tap to focus, otherwise you will get blurred shots. So make sure you use tap to focus. Boom, there you go. As you can see how beautiful the flowers have come. And what if I use the auto mode? Alright, let's use the auto mode and I'll capture and show you with this one. Now as you will see, the color rendition is not so saturated or not so sharp as with the scene optimizer. Now this optimizes very nicely and gives you some really nice results. That's why always use the scene optimizer when you are capturing flowers or very colorful images, I would say. Now again, as you guys can see here, now with this angle I can only capture one flower, and with this angle, as you will see, there is so much thing going on here in just one image. Just imagine the use of the ultrawide angle in pretty much any situations. So that's really awesome as well. So moving on. So guys, these were the little tips and tricks that I wanted to share you about the Samsung Galaxy S7 camera. Hit that like button if you enjoyed watching this video. Of course, I will be making detailed camera settings about the Samsung Galaxy S7 cameras. In that video, I'm going to cover pretty much any camera settings that's available on the S7. This was just a brief video on telling you how you can actually better utilize the camera's functions and take some really nice images. Hit that like button, share with your friends, subscribe to VickGeek. See you all in another one. Till then, take care.